Good morning. Thanks for joining me for devotion time this morning. Hey, listen, we're going to dig right in, jump right into the word this morning. We're looking at Matthew 5, verses 11 and 12. We are finishing up our series on the Beatitudes, and it has been so precious and so encouraging to hear these words of Jesus that give us instruction on how we are to be in this world. There is so much injustice. There is so much brokenness. There is so much hurt. There is so much pain. There is so much sin. So much of this fallen, broken world around us. And we are called to be a light. We are called to be different. If you're looking like the person that doesn't know Jesus, we better examine our heart, right? The end of this, of the Beatitudes, it's verses 11 and 12. And these are not happy, sparkly scriptures. This is real deal stuff. This is heavy stuff, so to speak. And it's a good challenge, though, because it challenges our hearts to not be just looking for the happy Christian life, but it's real deal. This is deep stuff. So this is what it says in the NIV. It says, "Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me." Remember that part. I think that's really important for us to remember. Just in our world, we're going to have lots of insults and there's going to be lots of hatred just because of our broken world. But this is right here. Jesus says, "Blessed are you when people do those things, insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of things evil against you because of me." It's because of him. And it's so in this context, it's because we're proclaiming Jesus. It says, "Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." Just a few chapters later is where Jesus is sending out the 12. And in verse 22, he says this. He says, "All men will hate you because of me." My goodness. Those three words have been ringing out to me all week long as I've looked at the scripture for this devotion. Because of me. Lord, remove me. Let me decrease and you increase. That's what my prayer has been all week. But this is the promise that comes there at the end of verse 22 in Matthew 10. It says, "But he who stands firm to the end will be saved." And verse 12 of Matthew 5 says that there is that promise. We're to rejoice and be glad because there is a great reward, a heavenly reward that's yet to come. And we don't even know how amazing and great that is because we haven't been there yet. I mean, it's only teeny tiny what we experience here. Any reward that we have here is so teeny tiny and insignificant compared to the eternal reward. So Father, set our hearts and our minds and our focus, set it in the right direction, we pray. I pray that our roots are deep in you so that as hard times come and as persecution comes, for your name's sake, Lord, I pray that we are able to rejoice in it and realize that there's a greater reward ahead. Keep us, Lord. Keep us in you, we pray. And may the glory of your great name shine bright through our lives, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Hey, be blessed today. Make sure you're walking just like Jesus. We love you guys. See ya.